What do Canadian pigs have in common with designer handbags? Both are targets of counterfeiters. Canadian meat is highly valued across Asia. That makes a Canadian meat inspection certificate valuable too. Fake certificates allow shady businesses to fetch a higher price for their phony products.
Food fraud is a global problem. It's estimated about $49 billion worldwide, and we have organized crime that are at the core of this.
John Keogh just spent 6 years in Asia as a food supply chain consultant.
How easy is it to fake a Canadian food export certificate?
Your passport, your driver's license, all of that can be faked, copied. So documents that move with shipments, whether it's physical or electronic, it's very, very easy to fake those documents.
Keogh believes the contaminated pork shipment that triggered China to ban imports of all Canadian meat probably originated in China.
Could it have been a fake product from a local source? It's highly unlikely that it came from Canada.
To know for certain, Canadian officials need to get their hands on a sample of the meat from the shipment in question. Tests can prove what the pigs were actually fed and much more.
We can also do DNA fingerprinting of the actual product itself and see if the animal is physically from Canada.
We're going to get to the bottom of it, and we want to resolve this as fast as we can.
Chinese officials say the pork was treated with ractopamine, an additive that nearly all Canadian pig farmers stopped using 6 years ago.
We want to understand where this pork originated from, who's involved, so that we can move forward and frankly continue and regain market access into China.
The branch of the RCMP that's handling the case also deals with international corruption and cybersecurity, a hint of how challenging this investigation could be. Mike Crawley, CBC News, Toronto.